All right. We are back with the last hour of the Pronati, Crow Inquisitors.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good time. It's a good time. Children are not being harmed in the making of this program.
Well, yeah.
All right. So I think we pick up back with Antonius as he kind of, oh, yeah. Like, what are you doing after you kind of treat yourself?
How exhausted am I?
I mean, pretty tired. You only got like 2 hours of sleep today, so.
Yeah, I'm thinking that after an episode of extreme discomfort in the bar downstairs, and then realizing that I actually bled through the shirt that I was wearing while working, mm-hmm. I decided, you know what, I better get the rest of my sleep.
Okay.
So I'm going to sleep for a few more hours and
okay.
Wait till other people come back and
sure.
Find out what happened. Find out what they find. Because I know Theo's nowhere to be found, and Alfons disappeared, and Dylan's off doing his thing. So mm-hmm. I'm just gonna sort of wait this one out, mostly because I'm exhausted.
No, I get you.
I mean,
yeah.
Blacksmith thing is fun and all, but overnight's kind of
when
a little
it causes
much.
You to bleed. It's probably time to stop.
No, that's the best part. Temper the steel just right.
Oh my
but
goodness.
No.
Well, okay then.
No.
But yeah, so I'm just imagining Cantarius' face when he kind of just realized that you just went up and went to sleep and never helped him. But I think what we do is actually we cut back to Theo real quick. And you said you wanted to try to like sneak over the wall. Is that what your plan was, Adam?
Yeah. What do I have to roll for that?
Well. It would be two rolls. It would be climbing and then stealthy. Unfortunately,
climbing, not agility. Climbing is its own thing.
Climbing is its own thing. Yep. Unfortunately, I don't think you have either of those skills.
I have. Wait. Climbing and
climbing
what?
And stealthy. Yeah. You don't have either of those.
No, I don't.
So I'll go ahead and add those to your list here.
I'm not gonna get them.
Well, it's you never know. I mean, it's just pouring rain.
And a completely vertical wall.
Yeah, you know, it's fine. People do that every day.
Do they?
I could do it myself, like in real life.
Scale a vertical wall with no handholds while it's wet. Carrying a trident and other material. Probably.
Not gonna lie, I probably could.
Okay, well, let's see if your character can. Go ahead.
Is it smooth stone or cobbles? Like,
I think I did specify that it was wooden palisade.
There's
so
always...
it's not that difficult to climb.
Okay. That's a lot.
But it is raining, so.
No modifiers.
Yeah. So yeah, no, you can't modify this. But. Let's see, so you're going to do your climbing first, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the ob for the climbing test is probably going to be see, this is the problem.
It's going to double.
What would be? Yeah, exactly, it's going to double. But I'm going to make it the actual ob it would be, so let's go ahead and look at climbing. See what it says. It's going to make an up two. And it's going to double the four. So.
Oh, I got it.
Nice. Awesome. And you even got two sixes. Wow. So even if you hadn't gotten those other rolls, you would have. Okay, so you climb just fine. So this is actually going to give you an advantage dice to your stealth roll because these are like linked tests. So you can actually put one modifier for your stealthy. And I think the ob will be... Well, the ob for stealthy isn't going to be that hard, actually, because it's...
So raining.
Let's go ahead and make it a two again.
What's the modifier?
One. You get one dice for that epic climbing roll you just made.
Damn it. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, wow. Why did you put in four? Put in two.
Oh, did I put in four?
Yeah. I mean, either way, it doesn't matter. You failed, so...
Oh, wow.
Luckily though, you do get two tests for those to learn them. You just need five more. where you learn the skills. But yeah, so basically what happens is you climb over the wall just fine, but the guard totally...
Hey, what are you doing?
Like, yeah, the guard totally knows you're there, and he's just like, are you kidding me? In the name of all that is good and holy, what are you doing? And he basically just, like, right as you get onto the top of, like, that, like, the walkway part of the wall, he literally just, like, comes over and, like, tackles you.
Like, hey, I just need to talk to the nun.
I just need to talk to the nun as you're being tackled.
That's basically what I was like, hey, I just need to talk to the nun.
Okay, so he's going to go ahead and roll power. You can either roll power or agility in response, whether or not you're, like, kind of, like, pushing back or just kind of drive out of the way.
I don't have power, so. What is that forte?
It's power.
Oh, yeah, I do, actually.
Yeah, everybody has power, but.
Can I roll both or no?
No, you can't.
Should I roll agility or power? Wait, okay, what's the difficulty? I mean, he's like a church guard, so.
Well, he's just a village guard. He's not guarding the church or anything. His power is a 4. So I'm going to go ahead and roll that. And he got 1. So that's your obstacles, 1. He doesn't have any fate points, so he can't reroll that 6.
It's wet and slippery. He probably fell into it.
Probably. He might have.
Probably slipped.
So yeah, you succeeded. You can very well push this guy off of the wall if you wanted to.
No, I'm just kind of like overpower him, like tie him up or something.
Okay. Yeah, you overpower him. And yeah, you can roll an untrained knots test to tie him up. Well, that's the thing. If you don't have rope, that's going to be kind of hard. This guy might have rope, but I don't think so.
Okay, fine. Can I just knock him out?
Yes, you can. Yeah, you don't have any, like, rope or anything like that, so. Yeah, you can knock him out without a roll. So you just kind of knock him out, leave him on the...
I like do like some like pressure point like.
Yeah. Do you want to drag him back into his little watchtower shelter place? Because otherwise he's gonna be kind of like facing the rain.
Yeah.
Okay. So that works, and then you can just climb down fine. Yeah. So you make your way to the abbey, and what do you do when you reach the gate? Because there is a nun, that same nun there. She doesn't see you offhand. She's still praying by her little incense candle.
Excuse me, have you seen a man coming through here? A man, not from these parts.
She doesn't hear you at first.
Excuse me. Hello?
And she kind of glances down, just, and you just see the barest, like, movement of her head through the flicker of the candle. And she says,
hello, what are you doing out here in this storm?
I'm here looking for a few people. A man. Not from these parts, but he came looking for a woman. The Arbus. Or
why does everybody keep mispronouncing that? Abbess. It's not that hard.
I thought there was an Arbit.
No.
The Arbiter.
There's an Arbiter, that's a thing.
The Abbess.
Yeah, he's an alien.
I mean, yeah, she doesn't respond right away, and I think I want you to make a persuasion roll to convince her to let you in.
Okay. Wait. What?
And your ob is 4.
Wait, I'm doing persuasion?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Where? Oh, there it is.
His ob should be against my seduction roll that I made earlier.
No, it's not.
But that's doubled since he's not trained.
Ob is 4.
Yep. Oh, crap. Dang it. Nope, didn't make it.
Yep, all right. So, yeah, she just looks down at you and says, this is awfully suspicious to have... And she just stops and she says, I don't think I'm going to let you in. Stranger, please come back tomorrow when it's not storming out like this. Maybe we can
knocked out a guy.
Maybe we can talk this. Talk then. You could try another climbing roll. To climb over this wall. Unfortunately, this is a stone wall. So that will be much more difficult.
Can't beat up the nun.
Roll seduction.
I could try. I don't know. Okay, what do I get? Wait,
there's seduction, persuasion.
Of being learned? Or is it still double? Or
yeah, it doubles if it's in being learned.
What would be the odds? Still four, so that'd be eight. So that'd be like impossible.
Yeah, it would be pretty hard.
Okay, hold on. Let me weigh my options here.
You might. No, yeah, there's not a whole lot in here to help you.
Can I do faith?
Yes, you absolutely can do faith.
Can I try and make the goddess control or me control her to let me in or something?
Oh, that would be a very difficult role.
Well, then what can I do?
Let me look. Let me go ahead and...
What would be an easier thing to do that I could say about?
Okay, so you have a boon. You could open-end a skill. You probably should have done that before you rolled persuasion. You could do a blessing to give yourself plus one dice. You could do aid to give yourself up to plus three dice. Let's see. You could do a minor miracle would be four, ob four. So you could succeed with that, possibly. That's probably what that would be, is just to have her let you in.
Yeah. So it's a four, you said?
Yeah, it's a four.
What did you say, the boon? What is that?
Boon is... It open-ends a skill. So basically, it automatically rerolls sixes.
It could do it to the persuasion roll. What does that have to do with faith, though?
Basically, what you'd be doing is say, hey, help me on this roll, God. And that's what it would be.
Okay.
But unfortunately, that wouldn't have helped you in that situation either.
Thanks, God. Yeah.
So I think what happens is you get struck by lightning. I think that's what happens.
Oh, man.
Because you have angered the gods just a little bit too much today. So I think what we do is we kind of cut away real quick as Theo is praying this. And you see Nirani and her son... the god of fire, and I don't remember his name off the top of my head, but you see like the god of fire and Nirani, and she's a god of water, and they kind of just like, Nirani is like holding her face like this, and she's like, he will not let me be. And then the god of fire just kind of looks over her and says, let me smite him, mother, let me smite him, it will be glorious. And she kind of looks at him and says, just don't kill him. And then she kind of like walks away. And then we go back to Theo. And I think what I'm going to do, so I'm trying to think of what you would roll against this.
The nuns take care of me. The nuns would take care of me if I just got struck by lightning.
Hopefully.
They're like, oh my gosh, this guy just got struck by lightning.
So I think what it's going to be is I think I'm going to give you an observation test to try to see if you can see it coming, kind of a thing. And like, because you've been praying, like, and you've seen that the response to your prayers lately has been storm related. And I'm going to give you, go ahead and make an observation test against a four. So ob four observation test to just see if you kind of see it coming first. If you hear the rumble, see the kind of flash before it hits you. And
dang it. I have the worst roll.
You have a six. You could re-roll it.
Oh, this is glorious right here.
I have to use a fate point?
Yeah.
Fine, whatever. What do I type in again?
Slash roll space 1d6, and I'll go ahead and make your fate points one less.
1d6?
Yep.
Oh, my goodness.
No. Do that again. That wasn't correct. Slash roll space 1d6.
Oh, 1d6?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Slash roll
space
1d6.
Yep. That is a success, but unfortunately it's not a six, which you needed to get another success. So just the barest moment before this lightning strikes you, you have a sinking feeling in your stomach and you're like, oh no. And then the lightning strikes you. So go ahead and make an agility roll against the lightning's agility roll.
Probably like 20. Maybe 25.
And it automatically open ends because it's magic.
Oh boy.
Oh wow. Oh, wow.
This is so glorious.
All right, let's kind of tally this up here. You got 1 success, 2 success, 3 success, 4 success, 5 success, 6 success, 7 successes against your, what is it? Grill your agility. So your odd is 7.
Yeah, absolutely.
Odd is 7 for your agility.
Oh my gosh.
So that means you take an ob 4 wound, which luckily for you is superficial. You know what? Yeah. See, that's the thing. Like, I think I'm going to bump that up a bit. Because technically...
The lightning, gray shade the lightning? Or black shade the lightning?
Gray shading lightning would increase it by 1. Actually, no. It would be white shaded because it's a god.
Yeah,
that actually makes the success go up by 1, 2, 3.
So it's 10.
So
now?
It's a 10 against your 3. So it's an ob 7, which is a midi wound. So you got a midi wound, which means you have 2 wound dice. Which let's go ahead and look at your stats here. Luckily, you have no stats that are lower than 2, or that are 2 or lower. So you're still up. You're not incapacitated. But you're burned. You're really, really burned. And basically what this means in terms of like anatomy and injury and all that stuff is... let me look at this.
Is there any way to kill the god?
Would that be his feet?
So you're definitely gonna have to get treatment, because the wound must be a midi wound must be treated before the conclusion of the session, or else the wound becomes a severe wound. But luckily, the wound ceases to bleed at severe. So if it does increase to severe, you won't die from it.
Wait. So what do I have to do to?
Basically, you could make an ob 3 health test in order to recover, and just by itself. The test cannot be taken until and unless the character receives treatment from field dressing, herbalism, apothecary, surgery, or an analogous skill. You have to get treatment before you can make that test. So you're going to have to beg this abbess to come in.
To just be all dramatic and fall over and like it had totally killed you.
Yeah, you can absolutely roll a persuasion again, because the situation has completely changed. So go ahead and roll your persuasion again. I would not recommend doing any sort of faith roll to try to get a boon on that.
Really. Sends a tidal wave and destroys the entire town.
3 or 4.
The ob is going to be... Say the ob is 3, and actually I think you can fork in conspicuous with this if you want to like ham it up.
And he just got struck by lightning, and they're nuns. Is this not in their character to help people?
Well, just wait. Go ahead, Theo.
Well, how do you fork in something?
It's modifier. So give yourself 1 modifier for conspicuous if you want to ham it up a bit. So what is your intent exactly? I think the nun is going to let you in no matter what. But I think your success on this roll is going to determine how fast they get you help. Go ahead and roll against a 3, an ob 3.
I didn't do anything.
There you go. Nice! You just barely managed to do it, even with 2 wound dice. The nun, like, rings like a bell. That she has up there, and she's like, "Help! Help! Someone is dying!"
Oh, sweet. Please get a nun to help you after you got struck by lightning by the gods.
Well, maybe the abbess will come help me, and I'll be like, "Oh,
So everybody who does not look at the stream right, the chat right now, Jordan Keller is watching us right now.
Oh, is
he? Hi, Jordan.
Yeah.
Hi, Jordan.
So he said he was concerned his internet wouldn't work. So that's awesome.
You're just picking up the very end of it.
Yes, that's true.
We got about half an hour.
I got struck by lightning because I prayed too many times. I hate them. I hate them so much. They're evil.
Don't you hate it when that happens?
I hate it when you get struck by lightning from the gods.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is what happens. Alfons, we kind of cut back to you, I think. And what have you done like right after you talked to the abbess?
I'll probably wait until she comes back.
Whoa, I just thought of something. Like, what if there's like a plot twist? Like, I fall in love with the abbess. The abbess. And like, it totally changes like my entire like perspective. Like, what? And she's like, I don't know, something like that. Like what? It would just totally change my character. Like,
it
everything.
Definitely would.
Like, that'd be weird.
And then we'd have to fight to the death.
Exactly. This would be like, we're like friends, then we find out we both like the same girl. We're like,
I'll persuade you what? To the death.
Yeah, you're like, oh, you're so good. You're like, you know, you should, you know, go after your, oh, what if, you know, he could. They're like, you love your wife, you can get her. And I'm like, you know what, you're right. Like, you could persuade me into that.
No, here, sorry. Drink this cup of ale I got you. It doesn't have bleach in it.
I have some of this.
There's no deadly poison.
Okay, so, yeah, Alfons, so what are you doing after you talk to the abbess?
I probably would have waited for her to come back, and, I mean, there's nothing really I could do in the meantime.
Yeah, so she doesn't come back, not at least until Theo gets dragged in. So you're kind of just, like, waiting in the courtyard or whatever, and you see a bunch of nuns, like, soaked nuns. Okay, so first you see nuns, like, you hear the bell. Actually, no, you don't, because I already said that the sound was pretty, it was dampening pretty well. But nuns run out anyway. And they seem to hear something, and then they go out. And yeah, the two of the nuns like kind of run out, and a short time later you see, a burned Theo being dragged by some nuns, into the courtyard, and they kind of look at you and they said, "Hurry, help us, please."
Oh boy, was he conscious?
Yeah, he's conscious. So actually, okay, I think what's actually happening is they're kind of like letting, like he's leaning on their shoulder, on their like their he's leaning on them as they're kind of like putting his arms over their shoulders, kind of a thing.
Yeah.
So they kind of asked you to help because you look like a big strong man.
Do I?
Well, you look attractive at the very least. You look healthy.
Okay.
Well, no, he has bullcrap wise.
Yeah. Fair. Does Theo notice me?
Yeah. I mean. Yeah.
Crap.
Sure.
And I'm just like, oh boy. Well, I guess I go and help him.
Alfons, you're here.
Just not respond.
I'm kind of just flabbergasted. I'm just like, oh man.
Does Alfons not know that I was gonna kill the
I mean, you were all kind of talking about killing at least Cantarius and Theo were.
I left pretty soon after I figured out where she was and started hearing talk of killing her. I'm just like, I'm gone. And I'm like, oh, if these guys are this far, David's probably definitely already this far and on his way there.
Jordan Keller says, "Dragged by nuns sounds like my idea of a good time."
What the heck?
Alfons, they may be coming to kill the abbess.
Yeah, I know that.
What do you mean?
We'll talk inside, alone, not in your shot of nuns. I already talked to her. I mean, no, I did not.
I mean, no, I did not.
The nuns are like looking at you guys like with really strange looks. So yeah, like one of the nuns, like the middle-aged lady who was up on the tower, is like helping with the other arm as you help with the first arm, Alfons. And then the other nun that was with or the other two nuns, like are kind of like walking behind you, like just kind of looking concerned.
Big burly nuns?
No, they're the ones that went out are kind of slight nuns. The middle-aged lady is, she's pretty burly, and she's helping the one helping Theo.
Anyway.
How does Theo feel about the church, by the way, and the popery and whatnot?
Well, that's the thing. He's from a different country, so.
Or whatever, but yeah. I don't really care about the
people. Okay, good.
I don't like the church itself, but this is different. Like, this is just like an off church, not like the church. Like,
I'm talking about the actual popery who.
Yeah, I don't like.
It'd be the papacy, but okay.
Not the popery.
The popery is something completely different.
Yeah, I know what popery is.
Nah, okay.
It's the little stuff in the dishes that you eat, right?
Yeah. Yeah, Jared, you're a genius.
Exactly. Okay, so yeah, we lead him in, and I'm just like, I'm trying to come up with some grandiose story. So where do we take him?
You take him to like a side room where there's like, you know, some like hospital bed looking things, and another nun kind of like comes out, and she is wearing some spectacles, and she like has like this little medical bag with her, and she kind of just sets it down and opens it up and starts working right away, and I'm gonna actually just go ahead and roll surgery for her right away.
Hey Jared, did you like seduce the nun, or you just talked to her?
Or actually, she probably has.
Well, I mean, she thinks I'm attractive.
Does she?
Big burly guard nun.
Yeah,
she does actually. Yeah.
No, I don't remember that part.
I rolled a seduction roll before my persuasion roll.
Okay. Well, that doesn't mean... Okay, I guess. It's fine.
So, yeah, the apothecary roll for her is going to be... she's using apothecary. She doesn't have surgery. She just has, like, herbs and salves and stuff like that. And so she's going to roll this, and she needs 4 successes. Unfortunately, she does not have that good of... Well, she has 5 exponent in it. So, I mean, that's good. That's like an expert level, but you are pretty burned. So let's go ahead and see where this goes. And this will take, let's see, an amount of time equal to treatment time. Requires 20 minutes per obstacle point, so it takes 80 minutes, so about an hour and hour and a half almost to finish this up. So basically, like, you can talk to Theo Alfons as this is being done. This takes about an hour and a half. So, and one, two, she fails.
She cuts your carotid artery.
So let's see what happens when you fail treatment for midi wounds. Oh, well, right. Actually, first, she needs to stop the bleeding. And technically, she only needed 2 successes for that. So she actually succeeded. So you are not bleeding anymore. You will not get a worse wound from this. And bleeding means, like, just the wound is getting worse. You're not actually bleeding, I don't think, because the lightning cauterized all of your wounds. but it's not going to get any worse than this, per se. So what's going to happen is she's actually going to... She realizes how serious it is, and she, like, has, like, other nuns, like, go run and grab some people from the city, actually, or from the town. So she goes, they go and, like, grab like a doctor. And so, like, you're
a doctor.
What?
Like a doctor.
Yeah. Something like a doctor.
Like doctor.
Which doctor?
So Thea and Alfons, what, so like while you're waiting, so she kind of like bandaged you up or put some salves on you to make sure that like you're not like going to get any worse or whatever until she can actually do the treatment necessary. So what are Alfons and Theo's conversation like while this is happening?
I'm waiting for Alfons to tell me what happened.
I mean, right now I'm just, like, standing in the corner trying to come up, trying to think of a way out of this. But there's literally, like, nothing I can do.
Alfons.
Yeah?
Alfons.
What?
Is the abbess safe?
For now?
Good. I don't know what,
I think what happens, Theo, is as soon as you start saying that, the ghost of your wife appears in front of your face, and so you kind of probably, like, stop mid-sentence. And she's looking at you with that, like, faraway look that she always does. She's not actually looking at you, she's just looking past you.
Oh, it's the worst.
And then the Nirani's voice comes from, the woman's lips, and they sound very angry. And basically what she says is, kill the abbess, and then disappears.
Oh my gosh!
How do you react to this, Theo?
I don't know, I'm kind of mad at her. Knock me.
So this is the thing, you do not have to play to that instinct. Even though you have that instinct, it's not like a thing that you have to do.
Then does he get some sort of a seizure like he did last time when he sees?
I mean, I feel like he's wounded enough that he kind of just like... Actually, go ahead and roll a steel test for me. Go ahead and roll a steel test.
Oh, that worked out so well for Jared last time.
Yeah, it really did, didn't it?
Oh, okay, I got an idea. How about, like, since I don't know what the abbess looks like, I'm, like, gonna kill her, and then I see her, and I'm like, I don't know what to do.
Well, like, that might happen. We'll see. Go ahead and roll steel. Just make it an op 3. Or no, wait a second. We actually increase your steel. We forgot to do the questions that increase your steel. I'm going to just assume real quick that your steel would probably be 6, and we'll kind of edit that later, but, like, I'm making your steel 6 now, so this is op 3 with steel 6. So go ahead and roll that now.
Oh, you're lucky to have a steel so high.
What the heck?
Oh, because you have wounds. Oh, yeah, but you have a 6. You have a 6, so you can spend fate to reroll that 6. And you only need one more success.
No, I'm not going to do it.
Okay. Or no, actually, because steel actually is automatically open-ended, you would just be spending it to reroll a failed dice. But okay, it's fine. Mark that difficult steel test.
Like it's almost like a heart attack or like almost like a really intense brain, like a migraine, and I'm just like like it's just like screaming. Like imagine like a really high pitched screaming in your head.
Yeah, definitely.
That's what it looks like. I'm just like on the ground, like eyes closed.
Just like, so you just like pitch right out of the hospital bed.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So yeah, like, how do you respond to this, Alfons?
So, I mean, it was right after he asked if the abbess was okay, and I'm just like, this isn't good, and I'm like, hey, I gotta go take a leak.
So this is a very obvious lie on his part, Theo.
You know that the goddess tells me what to do, though.
I mean, you kind of did tell everybody that. Well, okay, you said if I try to kill you, don't take it personally.
But they don't know what that means, though.
That's true.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I just judging from your reaction to me saying she was all right, I'm just like, ooh.
Something is going down.
Red flag. Something. Yeah. I don't have any idea that you're seeing ghosts of your dead wife. But I'm just like, something is definitely wrong. And I'm just like, yo, hey, I got to go take care of some clerical stuff with the nuns. I'll be back in a bit. See how the doctor's coming along, you know.
Okay.
You totally tell that that's an obvious lie, Theo. Like, you know.
I can't roll.
You can roll if you want to. Go ahead and make observation in response, Theo.
Hold up though. If Adam can't roll to, you know, deceive or to keep his you know change of mind hidden, then Jared shouldn't be able to roll to.
No, he did. That was a steal roll.
What?
That was a steal roll. That's literally what that was.
Oh, okay.
So go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and roll observation. Theo, roll observation. Alfons, roll falsehood.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna add fork and persuasion, bullcrap, and tall tale.
Theo, wait until Alfons makes his roll, and then that will be your ob. Whatever successes he got.
Wait, what's my ob?
Just set it at 1.
Okay.
Oh crap! This is like impossible to beat.
And I'm gonna reroll the six.
Why don't just wait? Wait until he rolls then. So go ahead and set your ob at 3, Theo.
Yeah, I'm not gonna win. So.
So yeah, it's like because of his wounds. So he's out of it. So yeah, so you just kind of like nod, I guess, Theo, and Alfons just like goes off.
And I literally just run. I book it to the abyss.
Okay. Let's kind of jump over real quick to Cantarius and Antonius. What are they up to? I mean, Antonius is sleeping. But Cantarius, you're crying.
Yeah.
You wouldn't do anything else for a couple hours still, you think?
Probably not.
Okay, so never mind. We jump back. Actually, oh, yeah, I think we do jump to you guys. Yeah, I think we do jump to you guys with the camera shots or whatever. And we literally just it's like dramatic music is kind of playing, so it's just like a little bit of a short montage shot where you just see Cantarius crying in like the corner of his room in the inn, and you just see Antonius sleeping. And then
glorious. Can I do a sleep check? Is there a sleep check?
There is not.
Oh, I was playing this role-playing game with a bunch of other guys one time, and they were it was one of those open-ended D20 type of things. So it's just roll for whatever. And the one guy rolled on his sleep check, and he got a perfect 20. He got a natural 20 on his sleep check. And so the DM's like, you had the most perfect sleep you've ever had, and you never need to sleep again in your life. You look up and someone left you a gift with a lot of money and an amazing breakfast.
Well, okay then. I don't think that's how that works.
Perfect 20. I mean,
the DM decides how it works.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Thank you. All right. So,
in D&D, there are no rules of physics and
anatomy. I think we jump back to Alfons then. Alfons, you intersect the abbess as she's coming to go like check out Theo. Like, she's with a couple of the nuns that were helped him in, and she's
gonna go check
she,
out.
She
Theo?
Looks very. Stop.
None.
She looks. She looks very concerned as she kind of like is clasping her hands and walking and talking with the nuns to her side. And he's like, he was struck by lightning? What does that even mean?
Okay, I look to her and I'm like, I'm visibly shaken and like concerned. I'm like, we need to talk now. Alone.
We already talked, and I already told you I will not go into a private conversation with someone I don't know.
The situation is worse, and do you want to cause a panic?
She narrows her eyes. I mean, go ahead and make persuasion, I guess.
Okay. Should I add seduction since she thinks I'm charming?
Sure. how are you kind of playing off of that with this thing you're saying?
I kind of like raise my eyebrows in a questioning manner at the end, like a, you know, like, yeah.
Okay.
What's the app?
Her will, which is 4, or. Wait a second. No, it's higher than that. Let me look.
It is.
Yeah.
But it's always been 4.
Oh, it is 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, never mind.
Need a new pair of shoes?
Yes. Got it.
Oh, that was close.
Okay, so yes, she just nods and says, I'll be there shortly, and to like the other nuns, and they walk on ahead, and she literally like just leads you into like the side room that's like right next to them in the hallway. And it's like a little I think it's like a pantry, actually. So it's big. It's like a big pantry. And she keeps the door open, but she just like kind of leads you in there real quick. And what did you want to tell me?
So yeah, I literally just tell her everything now. I'm like, okay, what? I might have not. Yep. I want them to escape, and it all comes into my plan of betraying the popery.
So wait, what do you do?
I literally just tell her everything, how I'm part of the Inquisition. I'm like, okay, so I may have not told you everything the first time.
Well. Okay, then.
The situation is much, much worse. I'm one of said Inquisitors, not by my own will. There's magic implanted in my brain, and if I disobey the popery called again?
Papacy.
I think you should be able to fork in bullcrap wise, papacy, just because this is the most ridiculous story.
Yeah.
On the
planet. Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. He's definitely gonna be. But again, like he's hear him out, and then you're gonna have to tell me an intent at the end of this. Like, what do you want her to believe by the end?
Yeah, I'm like, okay, so the papacy was about to execute me for crimes committed in my past, but I'm kind of a new guy now, and and they implanted magic in my brain, so if they find out I disobeyed the papacy or killed any of my companions, they're going to blow up my brain.
Is that really what happened? Like, is there magic in my brain, too?
Oh, it's not just in your brain. Your whole body.
Oh. Like, literally, they basically, like, casted, like, some sort of curse on you that if you, like, if you disobey them, they can tear apart your atoms, basically.
Only it was
his atoms.
Okay.
I bet you haven't heard that joke a million times.
I've probably never heard that joke before. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Add them up.
Okay. So.
Okay, so what is your intent at the end of that? So you kind of, like, tell her, you kind of tell her the truth.
Yeah. And how I'm, like, the Pope's son, and I'm trying to end the papacy and, like, the nobility.
The papacy. And the
main, like, the main religious and, like, the main political city, because it's all, like, super corrupt and whatnot.
Oh, that's something I get behind.
They sent us here to basically kill you and all the other heretics, and I'm trying to stop it. Because, and in the beginning, it was just to spite the papacy, but now I don't really know.
There you go.
Know why I'm
defending guys.
You. It's grown to be more than that, and you seriously need to leave now because the dude in there, the guy in there, is one of the Inquisitors, and he just tried to sneak in to maybe kill you. I don't know. So you need to leave now.
So I mean, that's another persuasion roll. You can add the dice for the tall tale teller because that is one of the most ridiculous stories that anyone's ever heard. And what else did you want to fork into that?
Seduction, because at the end I'm just like, you really need to leave because, like, the world can't lose someone as amazing and willing to go as far as you have to protect the people and, you know, share the word and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So, persuasion. Okay, so I'm going to do a persuasion.
No, wasn't coming from a serial adulterist. I probably think that was kind of sweet.
Yeah.
And a liar.
Hey, Connor, my heart grew 2 sizes this day.
See you with the Grinch before? Did you try to steal Christmas too?
Well, I'm not going to make that joke.
Seems like the Grinch, like, he was like a bad guy. He's like, no, now he's trying to save the day.
I'm going
to
slightly censor my joke. No, I tried to steal all the wives.
No, as I think about it now, you probably did ruin Christmas for Maddie 1 year, or 2 years, or a couple years.
Wait, who?
The
blacksmith's
Maddie,
daughter.
The blacksmith's daughter.
Say it again.
Oh yeah.
The blacksmith's daughter.
I'm gonna feel real guilty. So I'm rolling persuasion.
Remember, because he committed adultery.
I don't understand.
He committed adultery with the Maddie's mother. Remember?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah. I mean, you don't know this. You do not know this.
But based on the explosive,
you threatened your father.
I wasn't planning on doing anything.
Neither was I. I was drunk.
Oh, I love this session so much.
Connor,
you were the worst.
It was probably before. That's probably my daughter, to be fair.
Entirely possible. It is entirely possible.
Does she look like? We should roll for it right now.
The die of fate?
Yes.
All right. Let's go ahead and roll for it. On a one, she is your daughter.
What do I roll?
Just roll 1d6. Slash roll 1d6. On a 1, she is your daughter.
Wait, wouldn't that be bad for me, though?
Yeah.
D6.
She's gonna be your daughter anyway. I don't even care.
Oh, boy.
I don't even care.
Does the wife and husband know that that's my daughter?
Oh, wait a second. Let's think about this, actually. She's 12 years old.
Okay.
You would have been 17?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's possible. It's entirely possible. Okay, sure. Yeah, I mean, whatever. That makes the story horribly more tragic.
Yeah.
You're a terrible person, dude.
I'm trying to get better.
This is my friend. Why are you guys doing such terrible things to this guy?
Because it makes the story more interesting.
Okay, so persuasion, I'm forking in seduction. Mm-hmm. Falsehood for the whole making these guys seem much worse than they are.
Sure.
And tall tale, so that's 3.
How many dice are you rolling all together then?
9.
Make the ob an 8.
Oh, Caleb, why?
Because, okay, so this is the thing. The first persuasion roll you made, though you succeeded, it was with a completely different lie. It was with a lie. And now that you've changed your story, she's much less likely to believe you about this. She's so confused.
I didn't
she's
change
like,
the story, though. You, the story's still mostly the same.
I know, but, like, it's
you said, I didn't tell you the whole, I didn't tell you the truth.
Yeah. No, I said I may have left out a few important details everything now.
Now she's... She's suspicious of you.
Exactly. And she saw
the false. And if I...
Yeah, she made the observation roll also, so she had that doubt. So it's an 8. It's entirely possible for you to succeed in this roll. It really is.
Come on.
There's a fate to be spent there. You can roll that 6 again.
Can I spend a persona?
You could have before the roll.
Oh, what? Oh, I should. I kind of want to do that.
It's too late.
Gosh darn it. Okay, slash.
I'm still really depressed.
And it's a failure. So yeah, so basically she looks at you and she says, am I supposed to believe that? And she literally, she just says that and she just walks out.
Because I think she'd be like mad at him though. Because either she believes.
Oh, she's mad at him. She just
either she believes him and is like, "Wow, I can't believe you didn't tell me that," or like, "Wow, I can't believe you would think I would believe that," and then like, "You think I'm stupid or something?"
It's probably a combination of both. She, but this is the thing. Like, she, all of it is in her face. It's not in her words. She just says, "Am I supposed to believe that?" And then she just turns on her heel and walks out. And she she closes the door to the pantry on you.
I just look really like downtrodden when she doesn't when she says that. I'm just like. Oh man.
And then you hear the click of the lock as you're locked inside the pantry.
Oh boy.
Oh man.
Mm. Look to the left, there's some meat hanging to cure.
Yep.
Does she know what the Pope looks like?
I don't know. She's probably never seen the Pope before.
Alright. Well, from paintings and whatnot.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I guess you probably know what the Pope looks like.
Can she see the resemblance? Do I get another dice?
No, that wouldn't help.
Darn it. Yeah, that would collaborate at least one of the most unbelievable parts of my story that I'm the son of the Pope.
No. Fork in political influence.
Yeah. Can I fork in my reputation?
No, that's only for circles rolls and possibly resources rolls. But
I'm a sad boy.
So that's where we cut away from Alfons. Let's go ahead and wrap up the rest of this with the other characters. So, Antonius and Cantarius, are you going to do anything or just continue sleeping and crying? Like,
well, I was honestly hoping people would return to the pub before the end of the session.
Well, that's the thing. Cantarius could. Cantarius could come wake you up.
That's true. Or did we get individual rooms or like a suite of rooms off of a common area? Or
that's a good question.
Because I feel like my character might have just plunked himself down in a chair after bandaging up and be like, I'm going to take a minute and then just pass out.
Yeah, I think that's what did happen. I think this inn is like the most expensive inn in the town. And there's only one suite of rooms like that. And you guys bought it out kind of a thing. And so, yeah, there's a suite of like five different like small bedrooms all adjoining like a little common room area. So, yeah. Cantarius probably saw you on his way to go cry.
Saw.
Wait, Antonius, why are you?
Yeah, well, heard you. Sensed your presence. So, yeah, Cantarius, did you want to wake him up?
Probably a block away. Snoring. Antonius is asleep. Cantarius is crying.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, yeah.
Because I felt like using last night to work in the blacksmith shop.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, Cantarius, you gonna wake Antonius up or just?
Yeah, I probably will. I mean, I want to get a move on things. I want to get this over with. So.
You want to put on move on things?
Hey now.
That's Alphonse's job.
That's true.
So yeah, you wake up Antonius. Antonius, how do you respond to that?
How much sleep have I gotten?
How long you been crying, Connor?
I mean,
Antarius is like, I just need a hug.
I don't know.
For
maybe an hour.
Okay,
two.
So you've gotten about, let's say, about 2 hours more of sleep. So you've got about 4 hours of sleep. So
that's about average. I'm good.
Okay, so yeah, how do you respond when he wakes you up?
I'm irritable because I don't like being awakened, and I'm also irritable because I fell asleep in a chair rather than in the bed that I wanted to be in. Mm-hmm.
That's fair. I'd apologize, but I don't. Yeah, my character's not too concerned about your sleeping habits right now, so I'm not gonna apologize.
So what's kind of the exchange that happens?
I mean, I'm just like, yo, we need to get going. I don't even know where everybody else is. They might be killing people as we speak.
And you feel like you need to participate in that if it's occurring?
That's a good point. I mean, I kind of frown and say,
I think the rain is kind of cleared up at this point, so you no longer hear any of the raindrops. It's still cloudy, probably, but yeah, there's no more rain falling.
All right, I would just be like, all right, what should we do? Because I'm just looking for direction, because I'm just so, like,
yeah,
not in the mood for this. Mm-hmm. I say, all right, what do we do then? What do you suggest?
Completely out of character here. I have honestly not much of an idea of what I want to do at this point. I think that, you know, they're making a scene out at the Abbey. That's not really Antonius's thing. Mm-hmm. I can get you in and out of places if you find some place you need to get in and out of.
I mean, Alfons did just get locked in a pantry.
Can break stuff. I can, yeah, that, yeah. But I'm not going to be necessarily out looking to kill random nuns or, mm-hmm. you know, whatever. yeah.
So you say we should just kind of hang tight?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, cool. That works. Let's go ahead and go over to Theo, and the doctor comes back, Theo, and the nun, and I'm just going
to
go ahead.
Hold up. Can I try to break my staff?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Go to roll power.
No, I don't want to just, like, break it. No, I'm not just going to, like, use my fists and try to. No, come on.
Well, I was thinking, like, whack it against something, but what are you using to break it?
I've tried that before.
Okay, what are you using to break it?
Obviously.
My power stat?
No, well, okay, like, I've tried more than a few things before. Oh, how about I ask him if he can, like, unforge it? Like dismantle it in the forge. And melt
depends
it.
Depends on what it's made of.
I don't know.
Magic.
Yeah, he has no idea what it's made out of.
Yeah, literally, I ask you if you can, like, stick it in the forge and melt it, see what happens.
All right, let's do some fun stuff here, shall we? I've been waiting to use these stats since I leveled the character.
All right.
Let's start with...
Wait, what are you doing with the staff?
I am using...
Cantarius has this staff that he's could carry around for forever, and he's always tried to break it, and it's impossible to break. His son gave it to him.
All right. I'm going to do appraisal, figure out what it is,
okay,
what it's made of. All right. So then I'm going to fork in, materials-wise, what is it made of, tools-wise, what was used in the construction, because that's also important, particularly for deconstruction.
Yeah.
And then I'm also going to fork in artisan-wise, see if there are any particularly distinguishing marks, something I might recognize. Well, no, I guess that'd be a linked test.
That would be
right?
A linked test, yeah.
Yeah, so I won't do that right now then. All right, so that looks like that's three forks. Mm-hmm. What else was in here? Oh, can I fork in blacksmith as well?
No, it's a staff.
There's I suppose. Where's my button not working?
And at first glance, it looks like it's made of wood. So.
Okay. Why is my button not working all of a sudden? Hang on.
I'm not sure. It might suddenly just roll all the dice.
Yeah. Okay. Come on. Modifiers. Plus 3. And none of that. Base ob.
How many dice do you have?
7.
Yeah, it should be a graduated test. So just, go ahead and make it a...
Base ob on 1.
Yeah.
Cool.
Nice. You can reroll that 6 if you'd like to.
Not sure that it's important enough to me to go beyond just a normal appraisal, mm-hmm. you know?
Let me go ahead and look at appraisal here. Yeah, it looks like it's actually not a graduated test, and I forgot about that. Because there's like a specific, it would probably be an ob 7, to be honest.
Dread.
Yeah, looking at it right now, because it's, it would be an ob 4.
Because my intent was to learn about its construction. Mm-hmm. And not necessarily everything there is to know about it, you know? This would make sense to be a graduated test, but I don't know what the rules are on that, I guess.
No, I get you. Yeah, it would... Yeah, it's just a specific ob. But, yeah, I think I'm going to make the ob actually 5 in general, because it's like in the list or whatever, it says, like, antiquities are, like, ob 4, and then if it's magical, ob 1. Basically what you get from this is it looks like it's made of wood, but it is so freaking hard. Like, it is not made out of any wood that you've ever seen. It appears to be made of, like, just simple oak, but it's obviously not, because you can whack it as hard as you can against a wall and it will not, no dents whatsoever. Maybe a little scratch on the wall.
It's a good time.
But yeah, so like you have no real.
Well, what's inside of it?
I don't know.
The soul of his son.
Yeah, like something like that, or like some god gave it to him, or some patron saint gave it to him, and it has like special powers, but he doesn't know.
Patron saint of eyes.
We'll get around to it. We'll get around to figuring that out, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
Like a wormhole or something.
We'll figure it out, I suppose.
And then he finds out what happened. Like, he was the one who invented the flashbang and accidentally flashbanged himself in the past. And it's like,
okay, I'm just gonna say right now, Adam, it's not a time travel stick. It's not what that is.
No, he creates it, and then he finds out that the staff is like an open entrance to a portal, and he falls through it, and like ends up flashing himself in some weird.
You still failed to get back on track, roll, Antonius.
I try.
Okay, but anyway, so
the fortitude.
Yeah, basically, you don't have any experience with magical items of any sort. So yeah, you have no idea what the magical properties of this could be. You just know that it's not natural. So,
Okay.
There's something really big to this.
So it's clearly not normal wood, and it's clearly it's beyond anything I've seen before.
Yeah, definitely.
In terms of construction and strength and quality, I'd be willing to give it a go in the forge. Although being magical, I would suggest that you be the one to put it actually into the forge, so that if it does blow up in a big cloud of colorful smoke, I'm not the one killed by it, you know? I mean, magic and fire kind of all together, and breaking magical items.
So, is this a conversation you're having in character?
Good idea. Yeah.
I didn't laugh then. I'm like, that's a good idea. I honestly get concerned and kind of pale, and I'm like, yeah, I'm actually really concerned about what will happen if we actually can break this, so you should be careful.
Maybe you should have told him that before.
I didn't really think about it. I just want it to break. I don't really care. But after he's like, you know, talking about the concerns of what might happen, I'm like, I never thought about what would happen if I actually broke it. I just wanted to desperately break it. Mm-hmm. I never thought of the repercussions of the act of breaking it, because I didn't care if I died when I when I broke it.
Okay, so you, so Cantarius, you go ahead and stick it in the fire then?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Okay, so this is the thing. Like, you can't just,
yeah,
like,
we've got,
you can't just walk into the blacksmith's forge and just ask him to, like, use your forge, like, or just, or you use it without his permission. So you gotta ask him again.
I know. You wouldn't, yeah. Is this the that's, that'd be a circles roll to determine if this is the only smith in town.
Guy probably shouldn't be here.
Cast the little fire!
Yeah, this is the thing. You could find another smith. But the thing is, yeah, the thing is, Cantarius or Antonius would not, didn't know what happened with the smith before. Mm-hmm. He'd be just like, well, there's a smith right next door. Why don't we just go to that guy?
Yeah.
Actually, to be honest, Cantarius, I don't think you know that the smith lives right next door.
Yeah.
So you guys, you guys would probably walk in.
Yeah.
Can I?
How is this not going to blow up in my face? I don't want this to blow up in my face. I want that forge.
Could I have? Forge. Can I say something? I'm always making something. Could I have been making something for the blacksmith as like a peace offering?
Absolutely.
Okay,
definitely.
What would that be?
Maybe a doll for his child?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll do that.
So what is it made out of exactly? Like, what did you go and scavenge? Actually, go ahead and make a scavenger roll.
Probably metal.
You have a skill for a reason, so yeah, go ahead and make it scavenging roll. Let me look at what the ops are for that.
There it is.
To be honest, I think it'd probably be okay. So, what exactly you're trying to find?
I don't know, doll material.
What is it made out of?
Probably something softer than metal.
So like cloth or something like that that you could make,
yeah.
maybe like cloth and straw that you could like, you can put the straw inside the cloth and like sew it up and stuff like that.
Or just wood.
Okay. Make that an ob two.
What?
Very nice. I mean, you succeeded, though. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, you totally managed to scavenge that. Unfortunately, I mean, I think that's a roll, again, to make it, though. Because you just scavenged. You didn't...
Yeah. All right, so what I got the materials necessary. And then it'd be junk wire? No.
It would be mending, actually. Yeah. It'd be mending.
Okay. What would the op be to make a doll?
Let's make it a 3.
What?
You can fork in other stuff, though. You could fork in...
Oh, can I fork in junk-wise?
I mean, you already succeeded, so I guess it doesn't
matter. Well, but I want to succeed with style.
And it doesn't matter. To be honest... No. Wait. To be honest, if you fork stuff in, that makes the test less difficult.
Oh.
So, and yeah, you got a difficult test from that, so that's actually pretty good. So you should probably just keep it.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah.
Are you keeping track of all that? Because I'm not.
I'll probably go through and make sure that it's keeping track of all. A lot of the rolls that you've been making have been like rolls that wouldn't give you anything anyway. Because
okay,
like Jared's been using his persuasion, and not a lot of the rolls that he made were actually super difficult. But okay. Yeah, I'll go back through and check and make sure.
Except
got
the only
stuff.
One that mattered.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah, so you go ahead and make that doll just fine. So what does this look like exactly? So you have it on you though, because
I
don't know if you know
my...
this is the smith's house.
Wait, what?
You probably don't know that this is that smith's house.
Well, yeah, but let's just say I brought it with because
yeah, okay, that's fine.
All right, so how about when I do realize that it's her house? How about I realize it before I go in?
Okay.
And I'm gonna use the cash that I have and like buy them some meal or something like that.
You want to give me a bit of a heads up before we just go walking in?
Yeah.
Before I just go walking in?
I wanted to get some... I those are the first person I questioned is the blacksmith here. And he took it badly.
What have you done?
And his daughter walked in and
what
she was kind of mad.
Done?
I know, I'm sorry. So I'm going to go get like a pie. I'll be back in a sec.
Okay. I need this place. What have you done?
I know. It's fine now. We'll figure
okay,
it out.
Okay, so, yeah, go ahead and make a resources roll, Connor. And you can add one to that. Just buying, like, a pie, I think it's probably just resources one.
Oh, I don't have resources, so...
Yeah, you do. We have one resources. It's an attribute.
Oh.
So go ahead and roll that, and then one modifier is what you're getting with that cash.
One modifier.
Yep.
Base ob one?
It's an ob one, yep.
Nice. I succeeded in buying a pie.
Awesome. So, yeah, your cash goes away, so...
Is that a difficult thing?
It's actually your routine, because you used that dice, but you do need a routine. So, okay. Yeah.
Should I hit one of the circles?
I just did it for you.
Are you sure?
Yep.
I didn't see it. It's fine.
Okay, so, yeah, you buy a pie, and basically what... Yeah, okay. So you guys walk in. Antonius, how does this go down exactly? Like, what do you...
Well, I would think that while he's off buying the pie, I would probably go in and see if there was any more work he needed done.
Okay.
Anything that he particularly wanted me to work, you know, that maybe he doesn't necessarily want to work on, or he's backlogged on, or just something.
Yeah,
to busy
I mean,
my hands, so that I'm not walking in at the same time as Cantarius.
Absolutely.
I really, really don't want this guy to associate me with the man who intimidated him in front of his daughter. And...
No, definitely. Yeah, so I think what happens is you walk in and you see him like kind of like praying over his forge, basically. And he kind of like looks up when he sees you, or when he like hears you come in, and just like clearly like coughs or whatever to kind of like hide the fact that he was doing that. But it's pretty obvious. And he
kinda... Not necessarily like be obvious about ignoring it, but just be kind about it. Not
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, he turns to you and he says, "Antonius, what can I help you with?" And you do actually know that this guy's name is August, AGOST.
Okay.
So.
Well, August, I was wondering if you had any more piecework, something that needed to be done, you were backlogged on, if you wanted more help today.
And he kind of like narrows his eyes. He's like, do you want to be paid for this? I don't have much in the way of coin at the moment. I
would, if you would allow me some small time in your shop to work on a project of my own, then that would be more than enough compensation.
And he just nods, and he's like, that would be... I don't know what to say. Thank you. I would very much appreciate that. And he kind of just like shows you this little list of like his different things that he's been working on or whatever. And there's like an order of horseshoes that he hasn't gotten around to yet that the guards want. And he's been, he kind of like mentions in passing that the guards have come and kind of roughed him up a bit about it. But yeah, he basically doesn't say this out loud, but you can kind of tell that he's not in a good financial place. So,
mm-hmm.
And he basically kind of says he just got the metal necessary to like make the horseshoes. So,
Okay. I mean, he'd have stuff around horseshoe stocks. Horseshoes are a common necessity. You'd think he'd have the materials around.
Mm-hmm. Notice when you came in earlier that the forge did seem pretty bare in terms of scrap metal and stuff.
So. Okay, so this guy's pretty hard off then.
Yeah.
Okay. Here comes the difficult part, because guards are part of the establishment and
fight the power.
They took my livelihood from me. They took everything. I hate them.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Brussels!
I'm not going to do that because my throat is killing me. I shouldn't have even done that. Oh, my God.
Oh, Caleb.
That was a horrible idea.
Caleb.
Word of the wise, do not use a golem voice when you have a cough. That's a bad idea.
Mm-hmm. Good job, Gib.
Well, in this case, though, I think that I'm not run. I think I don't want to make. I don't want to run the risk of the guards taking it out on this guy. So yeah, let's. Yeah, I'll work on the order of horseshoes and.
Sure. Okay, so Cantarius walks in. Okay, so where do you go first, Cantarius? You just go like walk into the forge because it's like an open space.
I approach the person that I see first. Who do I see first?
Antonius. You just see Antonius working on the forge. Okay. And August went back into the house to work on like paperwork and stuff.
Okay. So I'll probably just go in inside.
Well, I guess the shop laid out? It laid out? Is it like an open shop with a house attached or is it?
Yeah, it's an open shop with a house attached.
Okay.
Pretty common.
Yeah, so I'll just go in there and be like, yo, sorry about before.
Mm-hmm.
I literally would probably just say that and have no other words. I don't know what else I would say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think what happens is, I mean, this is a, I think, what is this role?
Appeasement?
That's not a role exactly. This would be... It'd be persuasion.
Persuasion?
Yeah, so unfortunately you don't have that, so you're going to have to... I'll write it in for you. So yeah, you're going to be rolling that persuasion against his will. So... His will is... 3. So it's going to double to 6, unfortunately. But, I mean, you're still doing this, so... And I've already told you the obs, so you're going to have to roll it.
Yep. Do I get a bonus for the fact that I'm bringing a pie and a doll?
Yeah, basically what that is yeah, it's an advantage dice. It's like a bribe, basically.
So what is that? What do I get modifiers in?
1 modifier.
Just 1 for the pie and the doll?
Just... Oh.
I handcrafted it.
Okay, so yeah, I'll give you 2. That's fine.
Martha?
You can spend a persona on this if you want to. You do have 1 persona.
What would that do?
It'd give you 1 more dice.
Nah.
Okay.
And the base ob is 6?
Yep. Or no. Set the base ob as 3, because it's going to double automatically.
Okay.
Wow. That's a really bad roll.
You made him real mad.
So I think what he does is he throws the pie. The pie on the ground. And grabs the doll and he like shakes it in your face and he says, "You scared my daughter half to death today! What kind of a monster are you?"
Ooh, shots fired.
Can I hear him
out of my sight? Yeah, and you definitely hear him.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna
Darius walks out with a pie in his face.
Yeah. Bars may be a little too cold, but I'm gonna pull it out of the forge and beat on the thing. I don't want to listen to this. I'm just gonna drown it out with a couple extra hammer blows.
I think he starts to get a little angry.
Cantarius?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, he doesn't like this too much.
This is horrible. This is so bad.
Why does this not blow up in Narcos?
He just stares at him like...
How dare you not accept my apology?
Yeah, I seriously... he... Like, obviously he knows, he understands that the guy doesn't understand what he's going through. But, like, he...
Mind understanding and heart understanding are 2 different things.
Yeah, like, okay, but his entire world has just been destroyed right now. And now he's, against his will, serving the papacy. And he wanted information from him and trying to get it nicely so he didn't have to, like, get it in other means. And so... Hey, that was as nice as he could do it while still getting information. So I think he's just gonna stare at him. He's just gonna intimidate him.
Just with a stare? So what's your intent?
I don't think he has an intent. He's just angry.
You have to have an intent. What's the intent?
Get him to make him forgive him.
Oh no, obviously.
That's not gonna work with an intimidation.
He's so scared he forgives you.
Yeah.
Because that wouldn't be real for you. All right, real forgiveness.
It's a reaction. Would he necessarily?
Yeah, thanks real quick.
Yeah.
If there's a confrontation, I take the lead and never harm a child. Always inventing something. Those are your instincts. Yeah. You do have some traits that kind of come into this, though. Oh, you do have a call on for intimidation. Keep that in mind. So that basically means you can break ties in your favor. So. What are you thinking?
He's just probably so conflicted because he's like, I was, you know, just trying to do the right thing. And this guy is just literally freaked out and threw my pie on the ground. Like, I think that's the main thing is it's like, he just destroyed a pie. Like, what is wrong with you? Like, is this the idea that it's like, hey, at least eat the pie. Like, what's wrong with you? Like there's a nicer way.
Yeah, just
to...
if we were in August's head right now, he would absolutely be regretting knocking that pie on the ground because he's as we kind of learned with Antonius, he's not too well off, and that could feed his family.
So I'm gonna say that he is just really angry for a while. Does that concern him at all? Does that concern August? Does he hesitate? He just looks really angry.
He probably
he doesn't look really angry, but he can tell that he's like bottling up some rage right now.
Okay, like, so this is the thing. I think you should make an intimidation roll with the intent of getting across your anger. Like, making this guy understand how angry that just made you.
Alright,
I
like that.
Yeah, that's a will. That's against will, his will, so that's a 3 again. Actually...
Get any modifiers?
I don't think that's actually against his will. I believe that's probably against his perception.
Hmm.
Okay.
So that's a 4, so.
Do I get any modifiers for anything, or no? Probably not.
Or no, that's not going to be against his perception. His perception would actually help you, so yeah, it would be a 3. What? So, but yeah, you got a 6, so you can reroll, except you don't have any fate. So,
yeah.
So yeah, you just failed. So basically, yeah, you just kind of stew in the doorway for a bit, and August, like, kind of looks awkwardly. He does pale a little bit when he kind of, like, looks at the pie, but then, he just shuts the door on you.
Oh, no, I don't. I stop him from closing the door.
Okay.
I'm not.
Yeah.
I want to get across something. Okay. I'm sick and tired of this right now.
Okay.
I am.
You dug this hole, kid. Well, how old is Cantarius?
35.
Kid.
Yeah. All right, so yeah, no, he looks at him and he says,
"I got struck by lightning." I'm injured, but I'm not. I survived it. I'm in a monastery for nuns.
Convent is the term, or nunnery, if you must.
Okay, but anyway, dang, this is just so, like, emotionally driven. I don't know what to say.
Okay,
he would stop. What?
He stopped the door.
I stopped the door and I basically just say, what did I do that made you, like,
He said, "What?
I just say you don't understand.
Do?
You don't understand any of this. I am doing the right thing right now. Like what? Like you just don't understand."
Okay, so
I would just be emotionally freaking out.
Yeah,
at this guy.
He tries to shut the door on you, so it's an opposed power.
What? That's dumb. What are you doing? All right,
so go ahead and roll your power against this guy.
Wow, how did I get a 0?
What?
I don't know. I got a 0, man.
Oh,
I don't know what that means.
Yeah,
how did I get
3.
A 0?
So yeah. Because you just failed. So yeah, he just closes the door on you and then he locks
it. All 3 of his successes were 6s.
They were, yeah.
Player character with a fate point. But yeah. Nice.
So what do you do, Connor?
I kind of I kind of trudge over to Antonius with his staff. What are you doing with the staff?
Well, no, I don't have the staff yet.
Oh, okay.
Because you had decided to go after some pie.
Okay, so I take my staff.
I'm over there at the forge, pumping the bellows, pointedly ignoring you.
And you just throw it in the forge, Connor?
Yeah, I just throw it in.
Okay. And I think we'll cliffhanger there with that. I think we'll find out what happens with that next time. But one last thing we have to do, we're going to cut back to Theo. We have to do this recovery roll. So let's go ahead and do this. It's going to be, let's see.
The abbess left Jared, didn't believe him. You said the doctor or the one of the one people, somebody came in.
Yeah. The doctor came in, like the doctor they got from the town. And so he's going to go ahead and do surgery on you. And then the nuns are going to help him with apothecary. So this is going to be, a 66 against an ob 3. So let's see how well it goes. Yep. So they succeeded. So, you are going to recover just fine. And I got to roll for how long it's going to take. 2d6. So this is the number of weeks that it's going to take. It's going to take 6 weeks for you to fully recover. The first eye is recovered as soon as the successful medical test is made. So basically this turns into a light wound. In terms of like stats. So you no longer have the whole, two dice thing, but that other dice is not going to come back until 6 weeks from now. So you're still recovering. You're definitely a lot more scarred now than you were, even though you had a lot of scars, and yeah, you're burned up pretty badly. So the effects of that aren't going to wear off until 6 weeks from now.
Wow.
So this is a burning wheel, my friends. It's a harsh mistress. So let's go ahead and go through these beliefs and instincts here, and I have a feeling that you guys all earned quite a bit of fate.
Yeah, abbess. I can't wait till I meet the abbess. It's gonna go down so weird. Like all the.
Okay, so let's go ahead and start with you, Alfons.
Okay, I'm as good as Dellen, and I'll prove it by trying to take charge in his absence. So, I definitely did that.
So you're saying that like going to talk to the abbess was that taking charge?
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
I don't think so.
No.
What?
Oh, okay, so let's vote on it.
He's not taking a charge of us. That's what it was.
It said trying to take charge.
Well, taking charge of what, then?
Just taking charge. The situation, yeah. It could be either one.
That's why I didn't say you guys. I'm just like, the situation. Because most of you don't like me.
All right, whatever.
I want to end the papacy and I'll start by scamming the church. Definitely did that.
Mm-hmm. So what was exactly your scam this time?
Trying to get all the heretics out of the city. That was my original intention.
Okay.
Jared is once again locked in a closet.
This time by an abbess.
The most beautiful woman he's ever seen locked him in a closet.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I want to restore my reputation by making the party start to trust me. I may or may not be genuine.
I don't think you'd play to that at all, actually.
Yeah. I mean, a little bit with Adam, but...
Not really. You didn't try to You didn't make Theo try to trust you.
Yeah, you're right. Okay. I always entertain myself. I actually didn't do that this time. No alcohol.
Alcohol didn't get you into trouble. Always make the situation worse.
That always definitely made the situation worse. Adam got struck by lightning.
That one had nothing to do with you. It had everything to do with a man with too much faith.
Yeah.
Not enough.
Or not enough. rabble rouser.
Size of mustard seed and get struck by lightning.
No. Your faith has to find a subtle balance between the size of a mustard seed and the size of the head of a pin. And if it gets too much larger than a head of a pin, then you get struck by lightning.
Mm-hmm. I love that you wrote on your enemy circles literally everyone. Alfons.
I did that a lot. I'm pretty sure I did that the first night.
So your traits?
Okay, rabble rouser.
Not really.
Drunk? No. Mark of privilege? No. Unlucky. I got locked in a closet.
Yeah, I'll give you a fate for this time being unlucky. Okay.
This time. He got that far, though.
Definitely take fate for tall tale teller. That, The true story you concocted got you into a lot of trouble.
Yeah, I tell the truth and I get in trouble. Yeah. With that. Okay, rapey or wit?
Not really.
Yeah. And then none of the cultural stuff.
No. Okay, so how many? Five fate this time? Wow. That's pretty low for Alfons. Seriously. So yeah, go ahead and put that in your stats and skills and add that to the 9 fate you already have.
14 fate.
Okay, Cantarius. I think you actually got fate this time, Connor.
Yeah, I did.
What do you got?
I was spared for a reason, and I will administer my own justice. Not really. The staff is the key to figuring out what happened to my son. If I break it, maybe the bondage of my son's soul can be broken as well. I definitely attempted to do that.
Yes, you did.
Fate?
Yeah, so you get fate for that.
Alfons is evil in every regard, and I'll find a way to punish him like I have been punished, but I never even saw Alfons, except for the very beginning scene, so.
I'm gonna vote that one off.
Connor, if you want to, I am willing to let you, rewrite one of those beliefs for this session about the blacksmith. Either you can rewrite it to give yourself a persona point, so like resolve the situation with the blacksmith, or if you don't feel like it's resolved, you could make a belief basically about like I need to
like
do
the
something
aftermath of it?
Yeah, like I because
I honestly was just thinking about that though.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So what I kind of want to do is do something like I want to do the right thing no matter what, and no matter who thinks I'm doing the right thing or not. Like, mm-hmm. But I also don't know if I actually would think that right now. Like, mm-hmm. The belief might be the opposite of that. Like, these people deserve it now. Like, I might think that.
Okay.
But I don't want to be a bad person. like Antonius and I are the only two people who are actually, like, slightly good.
I never did anything wrong.
Yeah.
Well, there was that one time.
You killed a couple people.
Other time. And then those three guards. But, you know.
And to be fair,
they're part of the establishment.
So, okay. So I can only have 3 beliefs, correct?
Yep. Unless you have a special belief.
Why can I have a special belief?
It's
special
for, belief? You get it for from certain traits.
That's weird. I'm going to change the Alfons one simply because there's no positive thing that's going to come from this RPG of me attacking Jared's character.
And I haven't done anything despite you yet, so...
Yeah, you have. You
what? Name one.
With people, and your list of crimes was all you needed to do to spite my character.
Yeah, but you don't even know if that's true or not. They could all be lies.
Uh huh.
Yeah,
we've met you. It's very unlikely.
Yeah. So I still hate his guts, and like I want to kill him, but I'm not gonna make that my belief.
Mm-hmm.
I think it should be I want to do the right thing.
And what's like your first step to doing that?
What was my first step or what is my first step?
What is your first step? I mean, unless you already had a first step.
I want to do the right thing no matter what people think, I guess.
Okay.
I don't know, how would you put that?
That's fine, but you need something else at the end of it to kind of specify where you're going next with it. I always do what's right, no matter what anyone thinks. So what is
the thing? Are you already writing
it? Yeah. What is the thing that you're doing right now that's gonna be the thing that's right to do?
Yeah, I do. I definitely do smell the nest in there. That's so.
Well,
weird.
Probably stop us from killing the heretics that don't need to be killed.
Okay.
Yeah, that's probably it. I'm not gonna kill all the heretics.
I will make sure that
that we don't kill anybody that does not deserve death.
There is no needless death. Yeah.
Yeah.
Needless death.
Okay.
There's a confrontation. I take the lead. Did I get something for that, for confronting the blacksmith, or no?
Yeah, I suppose so. Go ahead.
Okay. Always inventing something. I was doing that.
It didn't really get you into trouble, though.
That's true. Never harm a child.
Definitely got you
into
trouble.
That got me
in trouble. That got you in trouble.
All right. Can we vote off the trait gluttonous and it was haughty, right?
But those are cultural, right?
You can vote those off, but again, like, this is at the end of the scenario. So after this, whole
I think it's a scenario.
At the end of this Estol little scenario, thing in the village, right. Then you can vote off a trait.
It's about perceptions.
Yeah.
So because of my race, this is how I am perceived. So for any of our character sheets, if at the end of a scenario we're like, hey, that doesn't fit your character, then we'll vote them all off. I just thought it was at the end of each session.
And it's only at the end of a scenario, it's only you can only vote one trait on and vote one trait off.
Okay.
So okay.
Has to be a little bit more.
You can do both.
You can do both, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Right. So how many fate points did you get for that then?
3.
Cool. So go ahead and add that to your fate there.
What do I do?
Add that to your little fate bubble. Down on the right on stats and skills. It's kind of like the mid right of the page. Antonius, let's go ahead and go through yours.
Mm-hmm. Is there a chance I could refine or add a belief?
Absolutely.
Or does that happen? Okay.
Nope, you're good.
Okay. I kind of like the flavor of Cantarius' new one. Preventing needless death.
Mm-hmm.
That does seem to be what I was playing to today.
Let's team up and have the same belief, and then this party will actually kind of be like organized and with the same goal.
Uh-huh. Well,
at least sort of.
Perhaps it would be something along the lines of, I don't want to be a horrible person, therefore I will rein in the impulsive and destructive instincts of the other members of the party.
Absolutely. That's a good belief.
It's a very good belief, morally.
You won't necessarily get persona for that unless you legitimately do that, like, in full kind of a thing. But you will definitely get fate for it every time you try to do it.
Do you mean, like, if he convinces them not to be violent anymore?
Well, that's the thing. Like, basically, the way to fulfill that belief and get a persona would basically be to stop them from, like, basically change their personality into not being that impulsive.
Or...
But if you did want to get a persona for it, what you would do is you would write that out. That would be the start of the belief, and then you'd have a first step into doing that, and then you could get a persona when you finish that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. So therefore, I will rein in the... Oh, how did I put that?
Impulsive members of the party?
I had a good... I don't want to be a horrible person, therefore I will rein in the... Bloodthirsty... impulses of the other members of the party.
And then your first step to doing that is?
The first step is to prevent them from I don't want to do this.
From harming anyone at the Abbey?
Yeah.
That very much might still happen. Especially if David gets involved.
So, oops. Ah! We have proof of heresy. There. So leave that kind of going both ways here. Mm-hmm. First step is prevent them from harming anyone at the Abbey until they have proof of heresy.
Cool.
Is that
awesome.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. So go, wait, yeah, go ahead and take fate for that.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? What is it now?
I don't want to be a horrible person. Therefore, I will rein in the bloodthirsty impulses of the other members of the party. First step is to prevent them from harming anyone at the Abbey until we have proof of heresy.
Okay. Cool.
Cool. Yeah, that's a good. It's good belief. So yeah, take fate for that.
I want to get my life back, so I'll prove myself by completing this mission.
Yeah,
working toward the completion of the mission.
Take fate. You still have not hurt the first noble you saw.
No, I'm starting to think that maybe.
He hurt me emotionally by ignoring me.
That's true. Does that count?
I mean, you didn't. I don't think you were actively working towards that, though.
No.
Yeah.
No, I haven't really been actively working toward ending the man, the oppression, whatever. You know. Yeah, maybe. I'm not sure about the way that one's written, because. It's like, that's totally something, you know, I despise the oppressive nobility. It's something totally something that Antonius would feel, but I'm not so sure about that particular therefore,
mm-hmm.
you know? And I can't just impulsively follow the belief and... Because Antonius wouldn't just impulsively follow that belief and then blow up his entire... And blow up the party that would cause him to be shredded into little bits and pile on the ground in a puddle of goo.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Mm. Yeah, let's workshop that one before next session and try to figure out something.
Okay.
So, yeah, instincts.
Instincts. If I see something broken, I must fix it. Didn't get me into trouble.
No.
Other than that, it's part of the reason I'm at that forge that day when Cantarius throws his staff in. So that can get me into trouble
You'll probably get into trouble next time, depending on how that goes.
I always believe I'm right. That didn't necessarily get me into trouble.
Mm-hmm.
I always have a knife on me. Didn't get me into trouble. Then we go through traits as well.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't look like
broken,
any of yours,
ambitious,
really.
Cynical, religious, haughty, gluttonous, made man, hand-eye coordination, unlucky. Cantarius has gone and made enemies with my friend.
Uh-huh. Yeah, go ahead and take fate for unlucky. That's fine.
And I did injure myself and aggravate it, but don't know.
Yeah, that's fine. Just take fate for unlucky. That's good.
Okay.
That's one that will very easily give you fate. So.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Adam.
So that's three.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Okay, my turn?
Yep.
Beliefs. If I do Nirani's bidding, I will get my wife back. I will kill this man for the goddess. It hasn't really happened yet.
Well, okay, so do you want to rewrite that belief to, I will kill the abbess for the goddess? Are you actually going to try to do that? Like, is that a thing your character will do?
I don't know. I feel like once I see her... I think the abbess is just like, you know, I don't think anything of her, but when I see her, I feel like she'll have some kind of influence on me not to. Like, I can't. Almost like, you know, like, on Snow White, that one guy was like, oh, I'm going to kill her. Mm-hmm. But he sees her, and he's like, I can't do it. I can't do this. He was like a murderer.
Well, this is the thing. So in this moment, like, right as when the abbess hasn't come yet, does your character believe that you will kill the abbess for the goddess?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, so let's go ahead and rewrite that. I will kill the abbess for her. Yeah, so you can go ahead and take fate for that. Because, I mean, you did, if I do Nirani's bidding, I will get my wife back. You did try to do that. I'm fighting whether or not to trust the gods. I'll work towards increasing my faith. You absolutely work towards increasing your faith.
I'm in trouble.
Yeah, it did definitely get you in trouble, too.
Which one is that one?
Belief 2.
No, is it P, F, or
it's
B?
It's F.
Oh, it's still faith?
Okay. Yeah. It's still fate because if you didn't actually increase your faith score, as soon as you do, then you will definitely get a persona for that. So.
Oh, okay. And do I get a third belief?
You can, yes. Yeah, if you have another idea for a belief, you can write that in and get fate for it.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay.
Instincts. If the goddess tells me to kill someone, I'll kill them.
Didn't get you into trouble.
No. Always judge a book by its cover. Not really. I haven't really. I feel like that'll come into hand next time because mm-hmm. I'll judge her and be like, oh, maybe she isn't so bad.
Sure, sure.
Never heed danger.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely take fate for that. You got struck by freaking lightning, for goodness sake.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, because she told me not to.
Exactly.
I was like, oh, shit, it can hurt me. I mean, she did.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And that's it, right?
Traits. You know what? Go ahead and take fate for determined, because you were very determined to succeed on a faith roll.
Where do I add that?
You just kind of like count it in your head. So you have 4 fate points. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I don't think the rest of your traits gave you any fate points. I don't think
believer
any of them really
maybe?
Got you in trouble. What was it? What were you saying?
Believer, maybe? Or I'm not.
See, this is the thing. I feel like if we were just kind of going at face value, you would get fate for never heed danger, determined, faithful, and believer, because all of them contributed to you getting struck by lightning, but I don't know if I want them to overlap like that.
Like, I'm not really... I mean,
you know what? Like, you got struck by freaking lightning. Take fate for all of those. That's fine. So yeah, you have 6 fate.
Six, yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'll go ahead and add that to your fate right now. So you have 7 fate. So, okay. Yeah. Awesome. So, I mean, that was a fantastic session, guys. I'm really glad we got there.
Yeah, I feel like I'm going to have to go against my own will and instinct next mm-hmm. game. So I feel like that's going to come in handy. Like, I'm going to see the abbess, and I'm going to, like, sneak up behind her or something. Like,
Adam, we just need to have a confrontation and be like, whoa, no. And it's like, no.
Problem is, you're locked in a pantry right now, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll persuade the door to open.
Come on, door.
Well, I mean, you can persuade maybe a passing nun to let you to open it for you. That's a possibility.
Yeah.
Maybe there are some.
Oh, yeah, the matronly nun who thinks I'm attractive.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, that's a possibility. Unfortunately, she is she's helping, like, Theo at the moment. They're doing their surgery apothecary stuff. So, yeah. I mean...
I gotta go, guys. So.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah, see y'all next week. Same bat time, same bat channel. Thank you for playing. It's been fantastic.
All right.
Adios, everybody.
See ya.
Bye.
That was very successful.